Swan, international side. Lauren Mahoga. Well, we heard about the class and we just witnessed it there. And from go to pope, fastest run, and a strong bike to boot. But in second position coming in now, a great back half of the run leader here today, show great patience on the run. He'll be looking at ways to get that swim and that bike up to the lead pack, but no effort left out on the course today for the rest of Australia. Going through in third place to claim the bronze medal in the Oceania Championships is Burns. And Burns, the athlete from New South Wales, will take the bronze medal. A gallant performance from him today. As we turn our attention, we'll next see a Queenslander in free. So Free, the Queenslander, will take fourth, and Luke Fate, the West Australian, will be very happy with this. Fifth place finish for him. He's managed to win the battle with the fellow West Australian, Brandon Swift, who will take sixth. So Hauser from the coach, and then Burns, Free, Fate, and Swift, three West Australian, six.
Stafford Green here, New Zealand, coming through, finishing soon. Got a bit of sprint on here for the minor places, Crosby and Dodds. Eighth and ninth respectively, well done lads.
Queensland, Matt Hauser, mate, demolition job there today. You went from go to woe. Was that the plan all along?
Yeah, looking training, credit to Dan Atkins as well. He's been really helping me through my swimming, my bike, and I think that showed so today, my performance. So credit to him and credit to, you know, my squad that it's pushed me the whole way, GCPC on the Gold Coast there. And it was great to have better swim than Adelaide, and then really execute the bike to perfection, so yeah, and the run just followed.
Yeah, and I think what everyone could see here today was you clearly looked to have control of the race. Did you feel as though you were on top of things, or did you feel as though you were stretched out there?
Yeah, well, the swing certainly took it out of me. I just really wanted to push it and get a good gap early. I managed to do that, and then about halfway through the bike, I kind of said to Liam, you know, we're holding, we're doing well. Just got to keep our head down and push towards that T2, and I think we did that really well, and credit to Liam as well, yeah. He worked really well out there, and happy to get the win.
So, mate, a lot of people talk about your potential and this, that, and the other. From you personally, at your own level of aspiration, where do you sit in terms of how do you see your future unfolding? What's the ambition that you have for your own career?
I've always had a great respect for this series, and it's certainly a great platform for juniors and stuff like that. But racing these races, I kind of try to push myself in the older races and try and emulate the performance that I would. Doing those races to the elite level, so I did that today, and I'm really happy with it, and I'm excited for the year to come.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, well done to our winner, Matt Hauser. Great result for the Queenslander. Well done to his coach, Dan Atkins. I'll grab Peter Robertson quickly, and Robbo, if I can have you for a moment there. Obviously, we need some better apps on Hauser. Your thoughts on what we just saw there today from the young Queenslander?
Powerhouse performance. It's often, you know, very, he made it look easy today, but it's difficult coming in with all that pressure on his shoulders. He did what he was expected to do, but it's a powerful performance. All right, Matty.
Yeah, he looked really in control, and it's very rare that you see athletes look like that at this caliber of racing, so obviously a little bit of a class above the field. Within that though, there's obviously a lot of effort from him. Overall, mate, your thoughts on the racing you've seen here today?
Perth turned on a nice hot weather farm, but it was good racing, a few blow-ups, which is always good, but good to see a few WA guys out front too.
Thank you, Robbo. Of course, our world champion, Peter Robertson, there with his thoughts. And when he won that world championship in Ishigaki, it was probably hotter than this, Robbo. It was a very hot day there.
Well done, you got it, you got it.
And some great racing for the local boys, as Robbo said. Three of the top six in our junior elite race, West Australia, sixth place. Brandon Swift, fifth. Luke Bate, and a very happy Paul McKay, his coach, second Lima coach. And these conditions really playing a heavy toll on these young stars. We'll make sure that we grab some fluids after this racing, ladies and gentlemen. These athletes have put it all on the line here today.
That's it, all the way. I'm telling you, 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 I'm telling you